Hey, what's up guys? King Scarlet here with a discussion that I am confident calling pretty good. All right, so you guys voted yes to me giving my thoughts on the Digital Next announcement, more specifically the Master Duel announcement. So, here we friggin' go. I have been scrolling through a lot of different thoughts and there are so many different thoughts. It was kind of hard to know how to feel because there was just so much speculation being thrown into Twitter, YouTube, everywhere. You like how I said everywhere as if everywhere is just Twitter and YouTube? But what I ran into is there were like two essentially different sides of the spectrum. One being, oh my gosh, as soon as this thing comes out, I'm dropping all the other simulators. It's perfect. It's amazing. The other one being, this already sucks, I bet. Konami, aka Komani, I'm so clever. You know, the skeptics. And it kind of seemed like everybody in these camps was at war with the other side and those in their own side to see who could have the hottest take on the announcement. Myself, honestly included in that. It was just crazy. There was so much excitement within the first 24 hours of the announcement. We Yu-Gi-Oh! Players get very excited and therefore very vocal about an announcement this huge. I feel like I've said the word announcement a lot in the last couple sentences. I'm going to try to say it less now. Announcement. Ah, frick. My hope and goal for this video is just to present you with all of the things we know and some of the points I've come across and just examine those a little further and have you leaving here with a healthy, neutral outlook on what's to come of Master Duel. I'm not planning to overly critique it and say it sucks, or to overly hype it and say it's gonna be amazing. Like I said before, we've got essentially two major reactions to this news. I don't think either of these reactions are completely 100% right, because spoiler, it's really too early to make any sound judgments. We don't know enough to know if we should be really excited or kind of bummed yet. You'll see. So in camp number one, we've got a lot of people that seem to be overly skeptical, outraged, worried, angry that this game isn't going to be completely and totally free, most likely. What did you expect? Why would they do that? Right? Have you heard of companies? You know what I mean. You've already seen probably a million tweets or something that start like this. Well, and they're already asking, why would anybody use this over something like EDO Pro? Probably because it's gonna be officially supported, you friggin' unsalted peanut out here tasting like the Windows 95 operating system. These people are on the other end of the spectrum, and I'm honestly not quite sure what to call it. Blind acceptance? Don't get me wrong, I'm so glad that this camp is excited and just really looking forward to this, and I never want to rain on anybody's parade. But they seem to be forgetting that it's very possible that this thing just sucks. To elaborate by sucks, I just mean isn't necessarily for the target audience that they think it is. We just don't know that yet. This camp is presenting a lot of could-bes and potentials and speculation as if they are what's happening and using those as the points for why it's gonna be good. But like, you know who's making this game, right? Have you heard of companies? Don't drink that Konami Kool-Aid just yet. I'm glad you're excited, but there is a healthy amount of skepticism that I don't want to say is necessary, but might save you some pain in the future. I don't know. Here are some positives about the game that we actually know. It'll be available on pretty much all of the platforms. It will be free to play with microtransactions. It's got very cool high definition animations that help walk you through what's actually going on in the game. Pets, or something like that, I guess. Differing rarities. An in-game tutorial. They're finally gonna teach people how to play this friggin' game. And at least some tournaments will be held on it. Here are some negatives we know. Well, the negatives actually come from what we don't know. First and foremost, and the probably primary worry for most people, how are we gonna get these friggin' cards? They didn't tell us that, which is a little scary. Like, why did they give us all this other information, but they didn't tell us that part? I don't know. I get the worry, but we also know there are microtransactions, and I'm not presenting that as a negative, but the downside and probably the negative so far is that we don't know what those are for. Again, just another, we don't know. And finally, we don't know when this thing's gonna come out. They did not give us a release date yet. So, why am I telling you all of this? Honestly, it's just because I've seen a lot of speculative posting everywhere, either in video, on Twitter, you know, everywhere. A lot of that is people just saying things, so if it wasn't confirmed or denied by Konami, I would advise you to just not really worry about it. Would it be cool if Master Duel led to supported esports teams? Konami support for creators when they use their official online client. Perhaps a future combining of TCG and OCG, even though they are going to run with a split region, I think, on the launch. And more people playing and watching Yu-Gi-Oh? Absolutely it would, but the game has to be good first and be easily accessible. We don't know that any of that's going to happen. Would it really suck if card acquisition is randomized packs? You essentially have to pay for your entire deck library twice, counting virtual and paper play. Tournament support is duty, and the virtual game isn't always caught up with paper play? Absolutely, those things would kind of suck, but they haven't been confirmed to be the case, so why are we getting upset about them as if they have been? My own personal opinion is that if they are going to go to a free-to-play model with microtransactions, the best bet would be to make all of the card pool free and all of the gameplay itself free, but incorporate a Battle Pass type subscription model to get better cosmetics, or exclusive cosmetics rather, and even free entry into online tournaments with prizing. Then free-to-play players could still have access to tournaments and cosmetics, but they would be paying a flat rate for each thing they wanted to do or purchase. This seems like a win-win situation, in my opinion, for the player base and Konami, because Konami would be making money, as they should, and people could just enjoy the game. I know that that point of view is an absolute long shot. Believe me, I know. I recognize my opinion is very wishful thinking. But I do think that's a situation in which the most people win. But I'm not in charge. Finally, I do want to say too, I just want to debunk this idea that if they get this transactional model wrong and they go with the Duel Links model, I don't think that's going to tank the game. I think it's going to be wildly successful. Not only do Yu-Gi-Oh! Players show time and time again after saying, I'm not going to pay for that they absolutely will pay for that, there's already an audience for a game like that. Look at Duel Links itself. I think players that do enjoy a game like that would absolutely hop onto Master Duel and spend their money and play the game and have a good time with it. What I'm saying is the question is not necessarily if the game will be successful, but rather who is going to be the main audience playing this game. Either way, I think it's going to do well. But like I said at the beginning, time will tell. There's just too much that we don't know to come to really any conclusion on if this is going to be really good or really bad. So I recommend just staying in that healthy neutral zone of being kind of excited with a healthy mix of skepticism and waiting for more to be confirmed. That's really all I have to say about it, honestly. Thanks again for watching if you made it this far, guys. I really appreciate it. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And if you do leave a comment, please keep it respectful. I know a topic like this can just really stir up our strong opinions and we lose our filters, but, you know, don't be a friggin' Windows 95 unsalted peanut, okay? All right, see ya.